One way to add a ton of value to your HubSpot CRM? It's simple. Add a little bit more about you. Hey, that's your email signature. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to customize it, create it, edit it. And if you stick around till the end, I'm going to show you two ways to create HTML email signatures for free. Let's go ahead and dive into this. Remember, if you need education past this tutorial, check out the description, the links below. That's what we do, monthly training or 1 and 2 day HubSpot workshops. Let's get into the portal and let's get this job done. All right, as you can see, we are in HubSpot and we're gonna talk about how to edit, how to create your signature for the HubSpot CRM. Yeah, we're gonna tell you a couple different ways that you can do this, a couple of different ways that you can get to the place to do this, as well as at the end, like I said before, we're gonna show you a couple ways that you even can create free emails or grab the email that you already have. So let's go ahead and get into this. Right here at the very top, you're going to see the dropdown that is able to be clicked here, and you're going to see profile and preferences. We're going to go ahead and click on that. Once we're on that page, we'll see where we can change our avatar and edit our name. Hey, that's not important right now. What is down here, you're going to see CRM communication, and you're going to see signature, and we can click this edit signature. And that's one way that you can get to the place where you can either edit or create your HubSpot CRM signature. Now, another way that you can get there is simply when you're at a contact. So you've gone contacts, then contacts, and clicked into a contact, you're going to see what looks like this little scribbly icon. It is a signature icon. And when we click on that, we get the same pop-up box where we can edit this email signature. There are two different ways that you can do this. You can create a simple email signature, or you can grab the HTML. If you have HTML, you can paste that in there. You're going to be able to see a preview. We're going to talk about that in a second. For the simple one, what you might do is you might go ahead and type your information in something like this. So as you see here, I have George B. Thomas, Impulse Creative, and I love email signatures. Now, because it's simple, we can select some of these items and make them bold. We could even select other items and make them italicized. We could underline, but be careful, that makes it look like a hyperlink. We can even do things like clear the formatting. We can do lists, unordered and ordered. We can add an image. So in this case, you might add an image of yourself, or you might add an image of yourself that looks like it has a play button on it, because you can also do a link. And so you could put a hyperlink on this image and then make it go to a YouTube video, which could be a video email signature. Oh my gosh, that's a bonus pro tip. Or you could just select some copy and open up the link and actually have this go to your website or to a place that you want it to go to. That's how you do the simple version of your email. Now, what if you want to do HTML? I'm going to show you two ways that you can create email signatures for free, but you might be like me and already have a signature. Now, warning, this is going to get a little nerdy for a second, but hang in there with me. And if you need help, feel free to let me know. Hit me up at George B. Thomas on the Twitters. Let's go ahead and dive back into this. So I'm gonna go ahead and go over to my email. Now this for you might be Outlook 365, it might be Gmail, it might be something else. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use developer tools. So I'm gonna do on the Mac Option Command I, I'm gonna get my developer tools, and I'm actually going to be able to select this box that has the signature. So notice right there, I've got that whole section there. I can click on that, and I'm gonna look and I'm gonna say, that doesn't look quite right, because what I'm actually looking for is the table row. So see how this table body, this table row, all of this kind of is in that section. I'm gonna go ahead and select that. I'm gonna right click, and then it allows me to actually copy this, and I can copy or cut element or copy element. I'm gonna copy element here. Hey, I told you it was gonna get nerdy for a second. And then I'm gonna come back over to my signature, and I'm gonna click on the HTML, clear out that break, and hit paste. And now notice up here or down here in my preview, I have my email signature in there. Now there is something up here that doesn't look quite right. Notice how there's that box there. And so what we'll do is we'll just come up here to the very top and we'll modify any pieces that we might not need. And boom, there we go. Look at that, table body and the table rows are there. So actually in that HTML that you copied and pasted, you could probably just find the main table body and copy that element and bring it over. But notice I have a nice HTML version of the email signature right here. I can just hit save, and then that's gonna automatically put my email signature in there. But one thing that you might have actually missed, we're gonna rewind for a second, open that box up. You may have missed the fact that because I started in the email signature of the contact instead of the actual profiles and properties, there was a little thing that we should have checkmarked if we wanted this to be our default signature. Let's go back and look at that. Notice we have this little checkmark, leave this box unchecked to only update the signature in the email you are composing, or also update my account signature with these three changes. So remember, we went to the area that was under our profiles. We actually want to update our profile too if we go in and do it this way. But notice that even makes it so that you could customize this signature for each individual email you sent out. So if you had a check out our latest blog post, instead of check out our latest blog post, you might put in here a special blog post for you, or you might title it something else, but you could do specific content for individual users that you're emailing through the CRM. But in this case, we're just gonna make our default one and get that created, and we'll go ahead and hit save. And now notice we've just got a nice little email signature there. We've got a place that we can start typing our email. And because I did that little check mark, let's go back over to our user profile here. We'll refresh the page. And when I hit edit signature, what I should see is that HTML has been brought over because I did do that check mark. Now, if I wanted to make any major modifications to this, I could do it right in this area. Now, like I said, I was going to talk to you about two ways that you could create free email signatures. One is you can come over to a company called YStamp. No, they are not paying me to do this part of the tutorial, but it's super easy. You can give them your name, your title, your company, your phone number, all of that good stuff. You'll be able to preview it as you build it over here. And when you're done, you'll be able to look at this. There's more. That's right. If you have a pro account, you'll be able to export it out to HTML. However, notice Gmail is free. So if you don't know how to build an HTML signature like we already have in our signatures, you could come over here, you could build it, you could put it into your Gmail, and then you could use the technique that I just showed you how to get that HTML out without having a pro account. Oh, snap. Anyway, the next way that you could do this is HubSpot has created a HubSpot.com email signature generator, and you can fill out this main thing. Look at this: name, last name, mobile phone number. There's even a place for social tabs. There's even a place for you to style it. You can even add, because hey, HubSpot understands marketing, you can add a CTA to it, and you can even add your certifications that you have, which it'd be nice if they updated these certification icons to the new HubSpot Academy icons that are out now. But it doesn't matter. You can show your thought leadership. You might want to create that. You can hit create signature. It's going to give you the HTML. You are going to have a preview. That's two ways with HubSpot or with YStamp you can create your HTML signature. But at the end of the day, what you want to be able to do is customize your signature inside of your HubSpot CRM. You want to be able to use content to help in the sales process. You want to have your face to make your sales and marketing more human. That's how you do a custom HTML email signature inside of HubSpot CRM. With HubSpot, it's that simple, it's that easy. So you see, folks, you can have an incredible signature inside of the HubSpot CRM. It makes you look more professional. You can use those links to get them to content they need to see, make your sales and marketing process easier, better, faster. Look, this is your boy, George B. Thomas from Impulse Creative, as always saying, happy HubSpotting.
Oh
Oh yeah, make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the bell for instant notifications, or do one of these things.